Hi, I'm SelmaTeacher7, also known as Mr. Barry by my students, and this is Clash of Clans on a Chromebook. And not any type of Chromebook, too. This is an Acer Chromebook 15. And what I'm doing is I'm using Remote Desktop to share my Windows desktop, which is emulating an Android tablet, which is running the Clash of Clans game. And then I'm sharing that desktop to this machine, and then I have control of it here. So if I go over and click on something, there you go. Now, on this, I'm going to show you what needs to be done so that you can actually use Remote Desktop to actually get to Clash of Clans on your Chromebook. Alrighty, well, let's see how to do that. So here's Clash of Clans running on my Dell laptop. And the way I was able to do that was I installed an Android emulator called Andyroid. And I have another video on how to install that onto your Windows 10 computer. And so as you can see, it's responding there. So we have it running stably here on Windows 10 or in the emulator. Next, what I did was I went to my Google Chrome, went to the Chrome Web Store, and installed an app called the Chrome Remote Desktop. Then I went in and I shared my desktop with my Chromebook. Now I'm going to show you how to find the Chrome Remote Desktop and put it on your Windows machine. Step one in getting Clash of Clans on any machine outside of an Android machine is to go in and find an Android emulator. Now, I'm doing this on a Windows machine right now. I have a separate video on how to install the Andyroid on your Windows 10 computer. So you install that. Once you have that on your Windows computer, install Remote Desktop. So how do we get that? Well, on a Windows machine, you go log into your Google account, open up Chrome, and go up here to, we have apps, and you want to go to the store. Once you find your app store, click it, and what you want to find is, it's called Chrome Remote Desktop, and it's this app right here. It's the one that says Chrome Remote Desktop Release Manager, and it's in the green background. There's many others that have a very similar name, so it is easy to get confused and get the wrong one. But it's this one here, and then click on Add to Chrome, and you'll say Add the app. There you go, now you have it on your Windows machine. Next thing that you want to do is, of course, start the app. And it starts up like this. And here it says, access your own computer from anywhere. That means from any Android or Chrome device that you're logged into with the same account. So right here where it says get started, click on get started. And it says that I have already shared this one. Now, if you don't have one that's shared already, click on this little circle and it'll ask you, do you want to share this computer? You click on yes, and then you'll type in a password that you want to use so that only people who know that password can access your computer. So let's go to the Chromebook now and see how to access the Windows 10 desktop from the Chromebook. So here we are on my Chromebook. Let's go over here to the apps. There's Chrome Remote. Now, if you don't see it here, you can go All Apps. If you can't find it in any of your apps, just go on to the web store and you can add it to your account. Once you've found it, click it. And click on Get Started. And here's my Dell laptop. Click it. You have to type in that PIN. Okay, now this is my Windows machine. See here, here's the icon. So I'm still in my Chromebook, but I'm accessing Windows. And I have full power to do whatever I want to in my Windows machine. So if I wanted to create a video, I could click on my AVS video editor and then edit a video or create a new video. We won't do that right now because, as the title of this video implies, we're going to find Clash of Clans. Let's go in here, let's minimize this. And I said that it was on the Android emulator. Right, so there it is, there's the Android emulator. Click on Start Andy. There we go. Now, find your app called Clash of Clans, wherever you installed it. There it is. And let's see how it starts. Okay, you're hearing the echo from the other computer. So let me put that one on a headset. There we are. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go full screen. And then I can go in and look at my village. Now I can tell you right now that there is a little bit of lag. But what we're going to try to do is I'm going to try to do a battle right now from my Chromebook, even though it's slightly laggy. Now, just for those who are not real technical, what laggy means is I click somewhere and my response is not 100% immediate. Instead, it's a little bit behind. It's a little bit lag. So when I click on something, not every time, but maybe one third of the clicks, I'm noticing a little bit of a delay. And that has to do with the speed of your network. So if you have a very high speed internet, this works even better. So what we're going to do is click on Attack. And I'm going to go Attack here. And let's see, let's find one. I have the worst army, and it is quite laggy. And as I said, I have a terrible army too. even with a terrible army that I had, and with all this laggy, I'm still making 2 stars. Oh dear. Queen. I lost the last healer. There was some little bit of laggy. Let's see if I can get 3 stars. I can probably get 3 stars on this pretty easily. Okay. I got 100%. I got 3 stars. Using my Chromebook, which is remote desktop through a Windows 10 computer, which is running the Android Emulator, which is running Clash of Clans. That's pretty amazing. And now you know how to do it. So that you can have as much fun as I just had. And my particular Chromebook does not have a touchscreen. Yes. Alrighty, now, once you've done with your session, you can click on right here where it says stop sharing. And when you click there, click OK. And then you can turn this off and you're back into your regular Chrome desktop and your regular Chrome experience. Well, I have to tell you, that's been one of the most fun videos I've made yet in this series. Please remember to rate and to comment. Please let me know different ideas that you may have on what we can do on the Chromebook. Perhaps you'd like to see Minecraft on a Chromebook. Well, and also, please visit my Patreon page. Feel free to donate there. Any donations would be greatly appreciated. Thank you again, and bye-bye.